Good morning. It's Wednesday, June 10th, 2020. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled, The Beauty of Holiness. Our scripture is Psalm 29. Give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. I was introduced to the scriptures as a very young child. The version of scripture heard in our church was King James. Memorization of God's word was taught as an important duty, key to having it, the word of God, hidden in our hearts. I always assumed that the phrase, in the beauty of holiness, was a command that I come to God as holy, forgiven and not steeped in my sinful ways. Now that was difficult for someone like me, full of youthful questions and doubts. I despaired of ever being good enough to come before God as holy. Enter the world of other translations. The version I've taken the time to fall in love with is the New Living Translation. This morning's verse hit me with a different look at an old friend, the beauty of holiness. The New Living Translation reads this way, Honor the Lord for the glory of his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. Instead of a command to come before God for worship in my brand of holiness, the command shifts to worship God because of his holiness. It's a command towards reverence, not a command to get clean and live right so then you're permitted to worship. This is that dress code thing I've bumped up against since the 1960s. It follows this line of reasoning. You come to God's house dressed in your finest to honor God. Now, that's not bad reasoning. If I were invited to the White House, I believe I'd wear a suit and tie. It's a sign of respect toward the one who sits at the resolute desk in the Oval Office. But I don't wear a suit and tie every day, especially to sleep in my own bed. Yet I'm commanded to worship when I get up in the morning, when I leave my house, when I return, all day, in everything I do. Colossians 3:23 says to do everything as unto the Lord. That's worship. And Deuteronomy chapter 11 says that the scripture is to be ever before us. The ancient Jews actually wore frontlets, little boxes on front of their forehead with little bits of scripture in those little boxes. They put it on their doorposts so that they would see it coming in and going out. Our Bibles are to be on the coffee table, so to speak. So, worship isn't confined to the church house, nor is there any amount of scrubbing up my life to get to a point of holy sufficient to satisfy any worthiness level before God. Now, that does two things. First, it makes me aware that I can only truly worship God when I come before him humbled and honest. As Charlotte Elliott wrote, just as I am without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come. And secondly, it compels me to remember that I'm always in that condition, and it keeps me connected with God's grace, which is only sufficient for sinners. I cannot be holy without his imputed holiness to my life. Warren Wiersbe, in his Bible study series, comments that, quote, true holiness is a beautiful thing to behold, and certainly the greatest demonstration was in the life of Jesus Christ when he ministered on earth. Sin is ugly, no matter what we may call it, but true holiness is beautiful and brings glory to God. End of quote. So, it isn't holiness that I can muster up or fake. Holiness is trusting in the God of Calvary, who brought glory to the Father with his life and stands with open arms to welcome us into that beautiful holiness. Our lives surrendered to that purpose of bringing glory to Yahweh is a beautiful thing. Let's pray together. Father, we understand that when we worship you, who are altogether worthy and beautiful, it's an act that brings us beauty to share with others. Allow us grace to receive your beauty of holiness. For you today, both ugly and beautiful are forever, except when the grace-founded worship makes an eternal exchange of one for the other. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.